In this video, we'll demonstrate how to use the Desmos graphing calculator to make nice looking graphs. The first step is to go to the Desmos website onto the graphing calculator part of that website. You can create an account on Desmos using your ACC account. This will allow you to save graphs and look at them later. So on the Desmos website, go into the upper right-hand corner where you see the question mark. It says help, click on that, and then click on the fourth circle which says regressions. Right, it suggests that you get some data. So go to the plus sign here on the left where it says add item and choose a table. Now I'm going to input, I'm not going to fill in their sample data. I'm going to input data from one of our labs, like so. Right, put in the X data and then the Y data, and you can just keep tabbing through and putting in the data. Just keep going tab and it will advance you through and you can put in the data. Make sure that you keep the X and Y separate. Make sure you know before you put in the data what is going to be X and what is going to be Y. One more data point here and we'll be done. All right, so we have put in our data for this particular graph. All right, so going back here, we then click on the plus sign again, and we click on expression. In the expression window, we type in Y1, because if you look at the data table above, the Y column is labeled Y1. We then put in a tilde, not an equal sign, a tilde, which you can find in the upper left-hand corner of your keyboard. And that's going to be MX1 plus B. All right, the equation for a line. All right, and you see here that we have all the data for the line here. We have the slope and the intercept, M and B, and we have a line drawn on the graph. However, we're not done with the graph. There's some things that we have to do here to the axis. We have to label the axis. And we have to make sure that we adjust the scales on the two axes so that we have a useful graph. Right now, this graph is not useful. This graph doesn't tell us anything. So we go here to the upper right-hand corner to the button that looks like a wrench, graph settings. We click on that. And you can see here that this will allow us first to add a label to the x-axis, all right, and to adjust the parameters of the x-axis. So we always use our data to set the scale on the axes. So we look over at our data, right? And we see that our smallest value for X1 is 16.5. So let's just say that we're going to set 0 to be the low value on the x-axis. And then we look over at the data, the maximum value for the x-axis is 98. So we'll say 100. Now, taking a look right now, the graph has automatically become more useful because we can see a little bit more detail in the x direction. But we still have to make an adjustment to the y-axis. We're not quite to where we need to be on the y-axis. So again, we look at the data. The minimum value for the data on the y-axis is 0.49. So let's just say 0 there too. And then we take a look and see the maximum value for y in our data table is 2.94. So we'll then say 3. Stepping back and looking, this is now a much more useful graph. We can actually see the information that it's trying to convey. If we then zoom out a little bit, now we can see the whole graph laid out in front of us. So the clicking that minus sign in the upper right will zoom out a little bit. You can also use the wheel to zoom in or out, the mouse wheel if you have one, to zoom in or out, or the plus and minus signs. So now we have good scales on the x-axis and the y-axis. That's going to help make this graph really useful. You have to have the right scale on each axis to get a useful graph. Now we're going to label the axes. Got to label the axes so that they make sense. See, once again, you click on graph settings and you see you can add a label to the x-axis. And in this case, the x values are the distance that we stretch a spring. So we can put in distance stretched. And we got to put units. If you don't have units on your axis, it's not useful. I'm also going to put in some spaces here to move that label over and center it up so that it looks real good. On the y-axis, the data involve the force applied in units called newtons. So I'm going to put that there. And again, I'm going to use the space bar to center up that label a little bit better. So now we have a very good looking graph. We've got the right scale on both the x-axis and the y-axis, so we can see the whole graph. We've got the two axes labeled with the proper units. So we're looking good. We only have one more thing to do. We have to title the graph. Right, so we got to put a title on. That's in the upper left. If you've created an account, it will allow you to title the graph. So we would call this distance stretched versus force applied. And we would save that. Okay, so we got a nice title. We got labels on the axes. We got the right scale on our axes. Now you can save this graph. What you could do is you can take a screenshot. I don't think this is going to show up, but you can click, you can right click here and you can say screenshot. You then take a screenshot of the whole thing, including the title, like so. Just click and drag, get a screenshot. So in our screenshot, we've got the title, we've got the data, we've got the statistics, and we've got the graph. We've captured everything we need. And you see, you can either copy it or download it to your own computer. If you copy it, you can then take that thing that you have copied now, go over to the lab report, right? So this is the lab report you'll be filling out, find the proper place to insert the graph, and just paste it in. Paste the graph in. Control V. There's the graph inserted into your lab report itself. So we've made a graph, copied it, and placed it into the lab report itself. And then we're done making the graph in Desmos.